Today we're going to take you inside the archaeology lab at Ferry Farm, where Judy is going to show you all about artifact labeling.
My name is Judy Jobrak, and I am here in the archaeology lab at Ferry Farm to talk about labeling artifacts. Why do we label artifacts? First, there are over 700,000 artifacts here in the Ferry Farm collection. And whenever we pull an artifact, for any reason at all, it's important to know where that artifact belongs when it's time to put it back. But it is also just as important to know where it comes from on the archaeological site. And our labels, believe it or not, has all that information on it. These are the tools we use when we're labeling artifacts. Scissors, tweezers, a paintbrush, labels that are printed on acid-free paper, our glue, and distilled water. For glue, we use gloss varnish that we dilute with a little bit of distilled water. We only use archival materials because we want everything to be reversible and we don't want anything to harm the artifacts. The first step is to cut out the labels. The size font that we use is a 4, which is very small, but it is very readable to the naked eye and it allows labels to fit on most artifacts. When we've cut out all the labels that we need, we use the tweezers to put them in order so it makes it easier when we're labeling the artifacts. The next step is to glue the labels onto the artifacts. With my paintbrush, I lay down a thin layer of glue. I pick up the label. Put it on top of the glue. Set it. And then I put a top coat on. There are other ways and systems of labeling artifacts. One way is to use a pen and ink and to write directly onto the artifact or onto a thin layer of glue. To do this, however, you have to find somebody who has excellent penmanship, who can write legibly, and who can write with the tiniest of letters. We prefer to use the labels that we print out on the acid-free paper, first of all, because you don't have to worry about legibility. They can easily be read by anybody. And second of all, we can use anybody on our staff and our volunteers to help with this process.